Fred Grubb with Rocky Mountain Construction, owner, founder, with my wife, Sue Ann.
And Fred, we've had the pleasure of speaking to you whenever you opened up Outlaw Run down in Silver Dollar City.
Yeah.
Since then, we've moved quite a big step further along in the chain of thrill rides, haven't we?
Oh, yeah. No. We keep developing product ideas, so forth. So it's all been exciting.
Yes. And yeah. Now with Goliath, is this just a step in the evolution of RMC?
It's a step in the evolution. Yeah, it's a step. I can't disclose what is coming, but it's a step, and it's a big step, obviously.
Yeah,
it's a very, very, very exciting ride.
I got to see you ride it today.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so everything came out just the way you wanted, I assume, because it certainly seems that way to me.
Oh, yeah. No, it's great. It's a great ride. It's action-packed all the way through.
And you now have another coaster, of course, opening now in Mexico as well.
Mm-hmm.
It's, of course, the conversion of an existing coaster, similar to what you did with New Texas Giant and Iron Rattler.
Yeah, yeah.
But is it also taking it to another more step?
Yep. Another step, another level. You'll have to get down there and ride it just to see. It's exciting also.
Yes.
So I'm going down to ride that. I haven't ridden it yet, and the reports are that it is very good also.
Yeah. And yeah. We also seem to hear rumors that there's things coming up already for next year.
Yeah.
I'm not going to go into anything there that you can't do it, but it looks like the slate is completely full for Rocky Mountain Construction.
Yeah.
Must be a fantastic feeling for you.
It's fantastic, and you're correct. Yeah, the slate's full. Yeah. Yeah, you're correct. I can't tell you what all we have going.
Oh, no, I know that. But, I mean,
but we do have the Sweden job, and I can say that for 2016 because that's been published.
Right, yes. Yeah. So, I mean, to just go from basically, last time when we spoke, basically just, repairing coasters, refurbishing them, building coasters for other companies, doing other type of amusement projects, to now being full-fledged, out-and-out coaster designer, manufacturer, and one of the most successful ones in the industry in such a short period of time.
Mm-hmm.
What is that like for you?
It's almost overwhelming at times. It's been a ride, I can tell you. It's just like a roller coaster ride.
But it's a roller coaster ride that just keeps going up.
it just keeps climbing for right now. We have new ideas coming out. We have new things, new ideas, although I can't tell you about them yet.
Yeah,
we have new stuff.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's get on to another thing. A lot of people are curious. Just what goes on a little bit behind the scenes whenever you are, like, with these current deals that you seem to be making with Six Flags. They really seem to be liking your coasters. How much of it is really left up to you and Alan and your team to decide what you're going to do, and what does the park determine what you're going to do?
Well, it's a team effort. We look at the site. Alan submits maybe several ideas and layouts and so forth, and it's a team effort and to get initially started and with the design process. And Alan, as you know, is very innovative, comes up with all kinds of ideas. We present them, they say yay or nay, and then when they give us the go, we start working and we start going.
So in a situation like where you have the existing coaster, I know there's limitations because you're just modifying and adapting it to what already exists.
Mm-hmm.
But that wasn't the case here. It wasn't the case at Silver Dollar City.
No.
That isn't going to be the case upcoming in Sweden.
Right.
So I'm just wondering, how much of a free hand do you get? I mean, do they just say it's confined to this space? What can you do?
We get pretty much a free hand. Pretty much, come up with ideas and come up with maybe a couple different, three different ideas and work together with them. And it's pretty much a free hand, though.
that's nice.
Yeah, yeah.
That must be terrific for you and Alan, to be able to do what you want to do with and working with the parks in that type of a situation.
It's nice that the parks have that kind of trust and faith in what they're getting and what kind of ride they're, you know, that they're going to get a good ride.
So there's one more bit of satisfaction you might get, though, also, and that's seeing the reaction to your rides.
Oh, yeah.
Not only from just the press and the media and the guys like myself, but also the writers.
The reaction is you stand in the exit line and watch, and so then you know what you have. That tells the story, right there. That tells the story.
And I guess that must be a really satisfying feeling right there, just to know that you know. I mean, the line still now for every one of your coasters is almost like they were on opening day, pretty much. They are
pretty
the most
much.
Popular coasters in the park.
Yeah.
So
pretty much, yeah.
Yep. So I just want to say congratulations again.
Thank you.
Thank you for taking the time to speak with us once again.
You're welcome.
And I can't wait to see you at the next event.
You're welcome.
Especially in Sweden, because that thing looks like it's just going to be awesome.
It'll be good. It'll be awesome.
Yeah. It'll be it'll be your biggest.
It'll be awesome. We will set.
What the park has released just looks phenomenal. So
yeah.
Can't wait to see you there, and I will see you there, right?
Oh yeah, okay. You'll see me there.
Okay, great.
Yeah,
we'll do it again.
Okay.
Thank you.
Good.